The collapse of the Carboniferous rainforest occurred approximately 300 million years ago. There were large swaths of forest, like the Amazon, all over the world, which encouraged amphibians to develop. Massive, but inefficient, tree and plant life captured large amounts of carbon from the atmosphere, causing the climate to drop by a few degrees and there to be less ambient moisture. During the period before the rainforest collapse, these tropical ecosystems thrived, causing atmospheric oxygen levels to reach 35%. This increase in oxygen led to an increase in the size and biodiversity of the rainforest inhabitants. The collapse of these Carboniferous forests was triggered by a shift in climate from warm, wet conditions to warm, dry conditions. In the late Carboniferous period, carbon dioxide levels dropped, which led to the cooling and drying of the climate. This transition to drier climates led to aridification. The rainforest receded to lower latitudes and were replaced by grasslands. The remaining rainforest became fragmented and isolated, leading to endemism and many species that had grown adapted to the lush rainforest ecosystems and gave rise to reptilian tetrapods. We can use several proxies to learn about this time period's climate, including fossilized organisms such as diatoms and forams, ice cores, and the rock record. We can learn more about today's climate by studying the effect changes in oxygen and carbon dioxide levels had on the Carboniferous rainforest 300 million years ago, and comparing that to our current input and output rates for oxygen and carbon dioxide in our world today.